Hello and welcome to Daily Prayer for Monday the 22nd of November. Let me start. Let's remember our wonderful Father in heaven. Let's say together, come, let us sing for joy to the Lord. Let us shout aloud to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before him with thanksgiving and extol him with music and song. For the Lord is the great God, the great King above all gods. In his hand are the depths of the earth, and the mountain peaks belong to him. The sea is his, for he made it, and his hands formed the dry land. Come, let us bow down in worship. Let us kneel before the Lord our Maker. For he is our God, and we are the people of his pasture, the flock under his care. So take a moment to still yourself and remember our Heavenly Father, our Good Shepherd. Decide to trust him for the coming week. To look back at the last 24 hours, or perhaps the last week, and give thanks for what has been good. And I'm thankful that my sermons are prepared for Sunday, as I'm doing this on Saturday night. Just for the joys of friendship. Of the team I work with. The joy of hearing that Sally McLaurin, who we've been praying for, is will significantly better, though not yet well. So we pray for God's healing, God's way forward for things that make us sad. And I've still not got a good price for the gas for the parish church for next year. We've still not got a treasurer. I'm shocked at the racism that we've heard about, particularly with Yorkshire Cricket Club. So too we pray for those on our hearts today, for Sally McLaurin, for Marion, for Malcolm, Bernard, Edna, Pat. Fathers on our hearts this day, Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And Father, we continue to cry out to you for peace in our world, praying particularly for Afghanistan, crying out to you that all the 20 years of education that the women have received for the attempt to rebuild and bring democracy, that in some way that would bear fruit and transform lives. So too, Father, we continue to pray for the Yemen, and for Syria, for Iraq, the Lebanon, Israel and the Palestinian territories. And we hear of human rights abuse. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Father, we cry out to you for your church, especially for all who lead, in whatever way. For your blessing, for your wisdom, for good teams to work together, for good and deep conversations. And through it all, Father, we pray that you'll take what we can give in our weakness and grow your kingdom and delight us and surprise us. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. So consider the day ahead of you, what you're looking forward to and what worries you. I'm looking forward to a good day off. For the week as a whole, I particularly pray that the plans for our Christmas tree festival will go well. That in particular Tony and Jill will have all the help they need. That we will work together as a delightful team. And Father, I also pray for a new treasurer and a good gas price. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. So speak, O Lord, as we come to you to receive the food of your holy word. Take your truth, plant it deep in us, shape and fashion us in your likeness, that the light of Christ might be seen today in our acts of love and our deeds of faith. Speak, O Lord, and fulfill in us all your purposes for your glory. In the kind of series of readings we're having, looking at some of the more smaller letters, we come to the last of the letters before we will change for Advent. So we're going to read our way through James over the next 2 weeks and the beginning of Advent as well. James, who we believe was the brother of Jesus, or the son of Joseph and Mary, who became a Christian after Jesus' resurrection. James, a servant of God and of the Lord Jesus Christ, to the 12 tribes scattered among the nations. Greetings. Consider it pure joy, my brothers and sisters, whenever you face trials of many kinds, because you know that the testing of your faith produces perseverance. Let perseverance finish its work, so that you may be mature and complete, not lacking anything. If any of you lacks wisdom, you should ask God, who gives generously to all without finding fault, and it will be given to you. But when you ask, you must believe and not doubt, because the one who doubts is like a wave of the sea, blown and tossed by the wind. That person shouldn't expect to receive anything from the Lord. Such a person is double-minded and unstable in all they do. Believers in humble circumstances ought to take pride in their high position, but the rich should take pride in their humiliation, since they will pass away like a wild flower. But the sun rises with scorching heat and withers the plant, its blossoms fall and its beauty is destroyed. In the same way, the rich will fade away even while they go about their business. I don't know about you, but it's not the most encouraging of beginnings to a letter. And as I think, how do we grapple with letters, especially bits that feel uncomfortable? We always need to remember that James, who wrote it, was a human being. And human beings are fallible. That's what the Bible says. We all fall short. But God has given us the reading, the letter for a purpose. And somebody said, you can lead people into truth just by telling them straight. Or sometimes you lead them to truth by listening to two opposing voices and helping people to think and go deeper. So, reading James's comments about asking for God and asking for God for wisdom or for anything else, and then in the second bit, you must believe and not doubt. That's the same Bible that has got Job. Job, who started off with that perfect faith, went through all that awful suffering, and his faith certainly wavered. He didn't always believe. He certainly doubted. He asked so many questions. And there's kind of truth in both bits. Job was eventually restored. Though some of his family have been killed. One day we will all be able to be reunited in heaven, and God will wipe away every tear. Faith in that sense must be based on what God has promised and not fanciful thoughts. But when we do have faith, it changes our whole approach to life. And I think just gives God opportunities to answer our prayer and work with us. That's the faith that I can have, whatever the circumstances. Faith that God is ultimately in control, not the sort of faith of, "Oh Lord, would you buy me a Mercedes-Benz?" And the words about those in humble circumstances taking pride, and those who are rich to take pride in their humiliation, are uncomfortable and yet true. We take nothing into the world, we take nothing out. But one day, God will wipe away every tear. We will feast with the saints in heaven. Amen. The dullness of our vision, Father, forgive. The weakness of our faith, Jesus, forgive. For the joylessness of our living, Spirit, forgive. Holy Three, have mercy upon us. Forgive us our sins. Help us to seek. Help us to see. Help us to serve you. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever.
Thank you.
May the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and your minds in the knowledge and the love of God, of his Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, rest upon you and remain with you, this day and always. Amen. Thank you for praying with me and for me. I hope you have a really good day, a good week. Bye-bye.